Okay, so we have the teams ready. The teams are ready, and the teams are the DTI versus and Gegner. So, DTI team, Russian lineup from EU1. Their house name is DTI, same as the here naming game, and they are actually playing for the glory of Protoss. So, the betting will end at around 5:30 PM. So before the final starts, then you can make the betting. So let's go to the game, guys. We have just 2 minutes left. So DTI, Russian from EU1, and Gegner team, EU2 server, and this is their house name and Gegner as well. For the lineups, right? DTI Russians, but and Gegner actually have a very mixed lineup. So they have German, French, Spanish, Portuguese, Slovenian, Serbian, Polish, Iranian, Swiss, and Austrian players. So quite mixed, a good, quite mixed group. Gotta be nice for sure to show. The experience they had, actually both of the teams have participated in many tournaments in Conqueror's Blade, so definitely something to see. And basically, yeah, they do win prizes as well, right? So they placed quite high there. For the season and achievements the teams have. And Gegner team, they have won the 2nd and 5th season on EU2, right? So they had captured the Reginopolis in season 5, and they captured the Conqueror City in season 2. And they have many players who are very, very high in the ranked battles and you know, top 10 and so on players as well. So definitely a lot of players to look at. For the DTI team, they have actually captured the Conqueror City twice and Reginopolis as well. So they have one more season win. And definitely as well, right? They have people who are playing ranked, who have very high score. The highest level player sold in DTI is over 3000 level. It's Ouma player. For the Endgegner team, Kenny Power have 2500 level plus. So we will see how it goes. For the players, I see we are ready. We are starting the battle right now. So let's jump into the game. Okay. We are loading in. So we have Endgegner team on the defense, and attacking team will be DTI. So let's see how it goes. For the DTI team, the person to keep an eye out will be the Hub Time. He's the highlight player. Let's see who he is playing with, Longsword. And for the Endgegner team, the okay, so their highest level player, most experienced player, is not playing in this tournament, so they have not provided any highlight player, but definitely the other names you should watch out is Kenny Power with very high level, Chimera with 2334 ranked points, so quite high, right? Both Chimera and Kenny Power actually have around 104 average troops killed per each siege battle. So interesting statistic to see. When it comes to the DTI team, this is Derevny. Okay, I have not confirmed this information, but according to what team provide, player called Derevny have around 150 units killed in average per every siege. Yes, goodness, 5:30, so before the final starts, this is where I will be closing the betting. Okay, let's fully focus on the game right now. So we have Endgegner team defending and DTI team attacking. Let's see how this will go. Let's jump up right away, see how the Endgegner team will prepare their defense. Definitely, they are going to start with the Definitely, they are going to start with the artillery. So you can see this is quite standard. I expect this to be standard for every team, the artillery battle to be conducted heavily. Let's see if the ballista players can kill someone. Good dodge. I mean, we are playing on the highest level here, so definitely we can expect dodges and no ballista kills. But we'll see. Maybe there will be a ballista shot somewhere landing and killing, headshotting someone. On the left and the right side, you can see the players. So on the up. Oh, and we have a kill. Screenlock have killed the player. I wonder what it was, not sure, but we'll see. Yeah, all heavy armor, pretty much, yes. Kenny Powell is playing medium armor with musket. We have Bullwave as well with the musket. All other players are on heavy armor. On the attacking side, on the other end, we have just one player, Ouma, with the long bow. So this is light armor player. Everyone else is heavy armor. You don't want to die here. You have only 3 lives per player. If you die 3 times, you are out of the game. Your team is playing with 4 players only. For now, let's close the statistics. Let's look how it goes. The attacking team is heavily pushing through the main gate. This is something we have not seen earlier. The defender team is using the bomber unit, right? The, how it's called? I forgot. Zikalian Militia, yes. Zikalian Militia are being used to deny enemy entrance. Look at the fire. Everyone burning here. Pipes not allowing people to cross. Shields covering everyone. And Zikalian Militia burning everyone alive. Your friend got killed? Oh, you have no friend anymore. I'm sorry for you. But the switch is here. The switch is here. Very fast switch. The attacking team of BTI have moved from attacking the main gate. They are moving to attack the left side. The Endgegner team is counter-rotating. They are moving more players to A. The push as well on the B is quite heavy. So we might see the B attack. Right, they might go and contest the B. They are walking down the stairs. Looks like it's gonna indeed be the B attack. Look at that. The amount of players who are walking in is quite big. On the map, a little bit of presence here, just to keep people attention. But most of the players are walking down the stairs. I wonder if someone will go to the back stairs, and this is what's happening right now. So these stairs are actually being defended and they take the attention of the Endgegner, while the whole team is right now moving to the back supply point. And let's see who will be the first to get here. This is going to be crucial. If the attacking team can capture this point, they are definitely in the great place to continue their attack. They can resupply their units, they can continue the attack. If they cannot capture it, they will have a long way back to the supply points. And remember, the time is ticking. We have only 7 minutes left. The push is coming in. So we have the shields first, the pikes are coming behind them, and Gegner team is actually playing very nicely with the counter rotation. You can see the flank is here. Azap's pikes are coming behind. We should see them advancing in a moment. The same thing is done by attacking team. Look at that, the push from the flank. And it seems like attacking team have the numbers here. They have the numbers advantage. A lot of dying is, a lot of death is happening. Many soldiers are dying. Let's jump in a little bit smaller, lower, to see how it goes. Long swords are healing the units. This is crucial to keep this long fight going on. They are not bleeding out. The attackers are not bleeding out. Thanks to the long sword heals, thanks to the good push. And what I said, the plus will be a crucial thing for the attackers to capture. And they have done it. They have captured the plus. They have done what they planned. They are taking out cavalry, ensuring that enemies will not flank them. And Gegner team is also taking out their cavalry, trying to stop the attackers. DTI is running around, clearing everything who is left. And look at that. With this single push on B point, they have taken out all the Endgegner from A point. No defender is right now on the A point. This is going to be captured very quickly, both B and A. The attacker team will have a lot of time to focus on the final point. Nice push, nice push. And look at that, they are not even taking A point. There is just a single player there. heavy push, heavy rotation to go here on the on the flank. They are trying to do similar push behind, which was done the previous fight. Let's take a look here from the balcony. Here we are standing on the balcony. Let's look on how the game will prevail. They are trying, preparing, but the Gegner team is not going to make the same mistake that the Ravens did. They are not going to let this happen. Look at that. The transition of the teams, they are pretty much flying around the map. Look at that. Super fast transition to cap zone. They are pushing in, flowing very fast. The death corner is actually very lightly occupied. The standard setup is there. Of course, they are covering the back, right? The back can still be flanked, so they have cover behind. But they are using quite standard tactic. This is something you can very often see if you're playing this game on Siege. You have the enemy's team, right? Like, separated by just 5 meters, just by this corner. Let's look from the defense. Defense is actually playing offense right now. Look at that. They are not having any trebuchets. They are pushing forward. Look at that pike advance. Very nicely advanced with the pikes. Very nice attack with fortebraces. Shields moving few meters. Fortebraces. So the pike units moving also few meters. And they have closed this attack right here. The attack is over. The attacking time of DTI. They have to regroup, rethink their strategy. Everything they built, everything they prepared is gone. Like that. And Gegner team with their very offensive push. Actually, this is something what they are known for on EU2 server. I played against them, with them, multiple times in Sieges, in Territory War. Let me tell you one thing about Gegner. They are as offensive as it gets. I think they are one of the most offensive players in terms of course of the gameplay. They like to push forward. They like to be very aggressive with their units. And this is what they did here. They didn't wait, they didn't let the attackers do anything. They just pushed them, cleared them out. They will have nothing of that. And the game have stopped or slowed down a little bit right now. We have this flank moving in right now, but this is quite small flank, so this will be probably cleared very fast, mostly archers here. Let's take a look at the units and the statistic of the heroes. So for the hero kills, we have 10 deaths on the Entgegner team. So this is something which is actually something they will have to watch out in the long run. Most of the players have just 2 lives left. So this is something that is might be, you know, in the long run, this is something that might be used by the DTI team. On the other hand, DTI team lost only 2 players. Look at that. Robert Disable and Felix. Only 2 players died. They have a lot to fight with. When it comes to the units, on the other hand, we can see a discrepancy in the other direction. The defenders have over 1,000 units. The attackers have only 800 units left. And the corner was set up. The death corner, this is this corner exact here, with a very nice cover here, was set up, but they were heavily shot by all these archers. Look at the archers here. Double archer unit, raining hell on the defenders from above. They are counter-attacking with the flank. This is very nice flank, but what damage has been done. The defense on the main point is scarce. They are doing nice work. Kashtan here behind with Condottieri. He's moving in behind to try to stop enemies from pushing. The defense team on the main point is also doing good job, but they are having very little units left. Fortunately, cavalry is here from both ends. They are cleaning up everyone. Seems like the attack on the main point is cleaned up once more. So, and Gegner team very nicely defended the wall. Look at that. So many archers dead. They have cleaned with their push of halabard behind. They have cleaned all the archers. No more archers coverage. Let's see how it goes right now. Very small amount of units coming in from Gegner. The defense is moving in with cavalry, but the counter trebuchet is here. Let's see if the trebuchet will fly. It flies and see if it will hit. Yes, right into cavalry. Fortunately, the trebuchet was aimed a little bit strange, so it didn't hit too many of the cavalry. And right now we have the double cavalry from the defender team running from left to right, trying to catch the attacking team off guard. Another trebuchet is here. Let's see how it went up. Attacking team have a nice mix of shields, pikes and short swords, as well as they have halberds. Defending team, they have just condottieris, pike units, and that's it. They don't have too many units right now. It might be problematic in the long run. If the attacking team can keep the plow of units here, they might move. But no, the defenders have resupplied. They are moving in. Units of pikes and halberds coming in. This is crucial for the defense. It's hard to push against pikes being braced. This fight is definitely very, very hard for both of the teams. A lot of deaths happening. The unit statistics, look at them. 300 units left for the attackers and 500 for the defenders. So even martellatory are there. Someone is left only with their martellatory units. So it's going to be very heavy fight till the end. 7 minutes left and just 300 units. Hardcore. Seems like the attack have once again stopped. The attacking team is running out of units. They need to regroup right now, and this is what they are doing. So let's take a minute to assess the situation long term. Attacking team, they are not pushing behind anymore. Behind is being the flank of the base is being covered by Endgegner. Endgegner team, this is exactly what I said about the death corner. You cannot be hit here by archers or anything. So right now they are staying here, healing with long swords, as you can see, and they cannot be moved, but attack is coming. Serfs are rushing, sorry, woodcutters are rushing. Pikes are flowing in. Seems like this will be the last push with only 280 units left on the attacking end. It might be the last attack, we will see. Let's see. It's very nice defense. The Endgegner team is staggering their pikes. You see, one pike unit finishes their advance, another one is coming in. So pikes after pikes after pikes. On the side, you have short sword coming in, fighting from both sides. And once again, Endgegner didn't wait, pushed and cleared out full attack. What is left right now is pretty much archers for the attackers and some pikes. A little bit of short swords are here as well, but they will die in no time. Let's look at the statistics here. 1,100 units killed here by the defenders. What is left is only 130 units for attackers, 300 for the defenders. Not too many. The top killers. Yeah, just a couple units here and there. Let's look at the statistics of the kills. Because right now it's going to be a deathmatch. And look at that! Actually the attacking team is... Oh my god, I focused on the statistics. Attacking team is winning the deathmatch! Look at that! They killed all the units. There is 15 people from attacking team alive and only 6 and Gegners left. 6 people from the defense are left. Look at that. The deathmatch. They are winning the deathmatch without units. Let's watch one last of the defenders. They are trying to survive. Heavy armor, long sword, running around. But only 5 of them left. Let's see if they will be enough to keep alive and wait for other people to come in. Everyone is running around the cap point, trying to stop the attackers from capping it. So this is something to watch out. Only 2 people left right now on the point. Another short sword is coming. The trash talk is starting to go. GG is coming in from the attacker team, but it might not be over yet. The cap is still not capped. Halfway done, there is a lot of short swords and they can stagger one by one. They can defend the cap with short sword one by one. They have some units as well, so it's not gonna be heroes only on the Endgegner side. Let's see how crucial it is. Let's jump back to the upper point because there is a lot of fights coming in right now. Another martellatory unit coming in. They will not do too much, but the short sword here, Legolas, he's doing massive job for the defender team stopping this. Magder, same stuff. You see, one by one they go, one by one, and the cap zone has not moved a single point for the last 2 minutes. They are doing amazing job. Another short sword, look at that. Kennepo as well, This is so good work of them. They have only 4 people left. Only 4 people left on the defender side, but they are staggering this one by one. Look at that. Amazing work. Amazing work with staggering. 3 minutes left only. Halfway to cap. To cap this point, about 20 seconds are needed. Will it be enough? Only 2 people left from Endgegner. Let's watch one of them. Tensei. His long sword dead. Magner, short sword. For sure he can survive longer, but will it be long enough? Who knows? Let's see. He is going to die. Just few units left and they will start capping. But what is that? Another defender is coming in. Let me try to move the camera to the Endgegner. Hammer have taken him and moving him away. This is something that hammers are actually very good with, moving units away. And last, the defender is dead. Oh my god, what just happened? What just happened? The 3 respawn times taken, indeed, the 3 respawns, this was crucial. And Gegner team, in the defender's team, in the first few minutes of the battle, they have died quite a big amount of time. Even if they didn't lose their units and they had the advantage of units, they still had disadvantage of the hero lives. And this is what at the end didn't allow them to spawn anymore. As you can see, most of them had 3 deaths. They couldn't spawn anymore at all. So this is what won for DTI. Congratulations. Big congrats to the DTI team. They have won the deathmatch game. They have won the life game. Holy moly. Let's jump into the analysis, because we have about 11 minutes till the next game starts. So let me open up the timer as well. Let's start the timer. Let's quickly run through the game once more on the post-battle analysis screen. So as you can see, they tried to go through the main gate. A lot of people died in the main gate, but in the meantime, this was a distraction. Remember, they have pushed to the B, right? And you can see a lot of the people dying on B. And then the team which from DTI, which pushed in the front, they have transitioned and moved to the back. And they moved to the back. Everyone was in the B point. They very nicely attacked the plot. Look at that amount of deaths at this point, here at 4-minute mark. This is amazing. What was here done is something like thousands of people died. Thousands of units have died here. But what was crucial since the start, DTI have not died. They have died only 2 times at this point, while the hero kills was at that point very, very big. Look at that. And Gegner team, they have died 1 people here and a lot of people here on this plus. Then another Endgegner's dying here, here, here. First DTI person, the second DTI player died here. Look at that. 8 minutes in, 2 DTI only died. So many from Endgegner. Another Endgegner player's dying. This is crucial for DTI. They knew what they were doing. They knew what they were doing since start. Another big dies from Endgegner here. Look at that. So much happening. And the last 2 minutes was pure deathmatch. Let's open up the units and continue from 8-minute push, right? They tried to go back. They seen that nothing here, and pretty much I can just fast crawl it because everything was happening up here. And at the end, this is what's important. A lot of heroes died from Endgegner, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 deaths only. Out of 45 lives they had, DTI only died 10 times. And Gegner died 44 times. And this was crucial. All right, let's jump in